to replace your negative thoughts with positive ones, you will begin to have positive results. This relates to positive psychology because in positive psychology, you use the attributes already bestowed in a person to help you become a happier person and live happier lives. Positive psychology was created and founded by Dr. Martin Seligman. Dr. Martin Seligman stated that positive psychology was the empirical study of positive emotions, strength-based character, and healthy institutions. Positive psychology also contains attributes such as kindness, originality, generosity, and humor to help you become a more positive person. Dr. Martin Seligman was the director of the Positive Psychology Center at the University of Pennsylvania, where they created and they still hold and conduct current research relating to positive psychology. When focusing on positive psychology, there are two main focuses. The first one created was the authentic happiness theory. The authentic happiness theory's main goal was to talk about and establish a person's happiness. They measure a person's life satisfaction, and their goal is to increase the life satisfaction of the patients. The second and more current theory was the theory of well-being. This theory incorporates the PERMA effect. PERMA stands for positive emotion, engagement, positive relationships, measuring and purpose, and accomplishments. The well-being theory studies a person's well-being and measures the effects of the PERMA. The goal is to increase the PERMA effect on a person and become a better, and help them become and live a better, happier life. Research and knowledge in positive psychology is continuing to grow daily, and through the increasing popularity, psychologists are now debating whether happiness in a person is obtained more through the treatment of positive methods or traditional methods. The main issue judged between the traditional methods and the positive psychology methods today is the patient's level of happiness. In order to further understand this, a person must distinguish differences in traditional method and the positive psychology method. The idea of resilience has not been studied for many years and has been neglected by most psychologists. Now through the new methods of positive psychology, patients are growing to be more resilient than ever before. This quote by Scott Lilienfeld suggests some issues with positive psychology. In this, he worries that positive psychology methods are not for everyone and the one-fits-all concept does not turn out to be the most beneficial for the patients. For example, for a defense pessimist, if they use positive psychology, it will result in negative ways. A defense pessimist lives their life in order to worry about the consequences and upcoming tasks in their life situations. If they use the positive psychology methods, this will only affect them negatively. Another example not to use a positive psychology method is when treating a low self-esteem patient. In a low self-esteem patient, it will only cause devastation and bad results. This is because in positive psychology, they use a method in which they repeat a phrase that is positively about them, like, I'm a kind person. If a low self-esteem patient repeated, I'm a kind person, it would only prove to them how they are not a kind person and how they should be. On a more positive side, the idea of resilience is now being bestowed in a person more than ever. Resilience is known as the idea of a person who has been knocked down by life's challenges but has not given up. A resilient person has a positive attitude and always finds a way to come back from devastation and not let life's fate bring them down. Now through the new methods of positive psychology, resilience is being established more than ever. Today, when psychologists use traditional methods to treat patients, they use the methods on how they feel would be beneficial for the patients. They base their judgment on the tragic events and their knowledge of the common therapeutic methods and the previous experience they've had in using those methods. A benefit of the traditional psychologist would be they develop a greater and more deep relationship with patients due to the long-term studies. But a disadvantage of the traditional psychologist is that they have little to say about a patient's life worth, and they concentrate very little on positive aspects in a person's life. So in conclusion, the key to develop the greatest level of happiness in a person is through integration. Nothing will wither away this way, and no and no positive or traditional method will outweigh the other. In this, they will be able to focus on positive aspects of life and cope with the negative aspects that have happened in the past. Integration is the main key to develop the best happiness in a person.